Well, I asked the Holy Spirit, I said, why are we not getting to this vision of oneness? What is wrong? And can you please tell me, what is there anything I can look at that will, you know, remove the blockage? And I asked the Holy Spirit, just give me the answer, and it gave an answer. And I never thought of this before, actually. So it's likely to be very, very fruitful. And so it's super important that we look at this now. Keep in mind that this whole dream scenario, this fraudulent hoax, self-deception that the light is presenting to us, was based on our desire to be greater than God. Okay, so having this desire to be greater than God, we seem to fall into this dreamlike scenario that's actually terrible. Now, when we asked light, we requested light to present our kingdom to us, present the evidence that we're greater than God. So it's doing that with this fake scenario, light conflicting with light, etc. Now, we know that, we believe that we were able to transcend God and be greater than God. So actually, we are, what the light does is it makes us believe that there's something in this dream, there's something in our new kingdom that is actually wants to transcend and be greater than us, right? You see, the principle of creation, a part of creation separating from the rest of creation and being greater and a new creation, that has to be present. Otherwise, we couldn't believe that we did what we did. So light is presenting this belief system that there's something within this, our quote-unquote new kingdom, that is wants to separate from us and transcend us and be greater than us and control us. So we're insecure, or an insecure God, as it were. And what it really is, actually, what light does is it's actually the real self that we are, the true self that we truly are, who wants to turn his attention off of this dream and repent. The light, the belief system that the light is presenting to us, tells us that that is the danger. That is the one that is trying to usurp and transcend this kingdom and be greater than you are, than the new God. And therefore, you must prevent that at all costs. So if you wonder, why does this presentation of the light, which we requested, seem to be so evil, and so opposed to our relinquishing our freedom, so opposed to it because we asked it to? What kind of kingdom? How can we play God if we feel there's some part of our kingdom that is going to usurp us, usurp our position and replace us? Well, we wouldn't feel like we're God then, right? So the light has to defend against this at all costs, in order to give us the conviction that, hey, we really are God, that there's no way that this is gonna happen to us. Because light, you know, that there's all these defenses against it. So it is true that the light does try and stop us from enlightenment, from realization. Absolutely it does. Now, so we have to see this dynamic and see where it's coming from. This is our own desire to be prime creator. Part of that is the light has to admit that it is possible to separate from reality and displace the God of reality, because that's what we think of what we've done, right? If it didn't admit that, how can we even believe that what we did was possible? But it also has to insist that it's not going to happen, because it's completely protected and defended against. And so we say, okay. So we do meet this incredible resistance in trying to accept the vision of oneness. What we need to do is thank that resistance. As we feel it, instead of struggling or getting upset, angry, say, oh, there's this resistance insisting that I cannot do this. Thank you so much for being so evil. thank you so much for being so evil and honoring my request. Thank you very much. And then just continue on. So you continue going towards it. The light will claim, you're going to make everybody else unhappy. You know, says, well, and just say, well, thank you for presenting such an evil falsity to me. I really appreciate it. Really appreciate that, honoring my request. That's part of honoring my request that I asked you to do. Did a great, great job, great job. And just continue on, right on to the vision of oneness. We have to acknowledge, it's part of repentance, acknowledge the consequences of what we tried to do. It absolutely includes trying at all costs to prevent us to drop this dream, because the light will tell us, you're just going to fall into a dream, right? It has to say that, because that's denying what actually happened, which is we fell into a dream by requesting this. So it says by waking up is actually falling into a dream. That's what light insists upon. It's a total lie. So you might say the light is being a total liar to us by our request, you see. So what we have to do is thank the light for lying to us instead of getting really agitated and upset and saying, I gotta defeat you. Oh, thank you. What a vicious lie that is. Light, thank you so much for honoring my request. And now I'm going to make a new request like that. And so you're acknowledging that you're trusting the light. Say, light, you're doing exactly what I asked you to do. You're insisting that this vision of oneness is going to cause me to fall into some dreadful, horrible dream that I'm never going to wake from. I'm going to hate it. You know, and I'm going to cause everyone else's unhappiness. I'm going to cause blah, 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 blah. All these lies. You say, thank you for telling all these lies. That's wonderful. I really appreciate it. And then go do it anyway. Request your attention shift to the vision of oneness. Of course it's going to insist that you're going to die. It's disastrous. Any and all excuses it can use, any lies it can tell you, it will use to try and dissuade you. Because you asked that. You asked that. What good is it to be a god if you can drop being a god? Right? If you can, are you really God if you can stop being God? So the light insists that no, you must remain as you are. You cannot change. You cannot see the vision of oneness. You must keep believing in what I'm showing you is true and real and all this. Because if you don't, you'll stop being God. And if you stop being God, you realize you never were God. Right? So you can see the bizarre position we put ourselves in. But by looking at it just clearly like this, in the light of good humor, lightheartedness, let's just look at this. You say, oh, of course, I can see this dynamic. The light has to oppose it, as if our very godness depended upon it. And then, of course, since the light is insisting that we're God, which we told it to do, presenting all this evidence that we're God, the light will say, well, you're trying to destroy God. See, you're trying to attack and destroy God by shifting your attention. And if you do that, you will kill God. No, we'll just realize that we never were God, not the prime creator. We never were the prime creator. That's not killing God. Realizing we never were the prime creator, how's that killing God? It's only the end of our pretension. But of course, light won't tell us that. See, the problem is that light won't tell us the truth because we told light to lie to us. Telling us we're prime creator, of course, is a complete lie. So light is absolutely lying to us, but per our request. Since we have this continuity problem, we can't drop it all at once. We can't go to light and say, hey, light, tell us the truth about this at the level of the lie. You see, bring some light into this. No, it will not. It will keep lying. So what we have to do is turn to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is light also, but is light coming from an idea of God, which is to heal the continuity problem. Heal the continuity problem. So for answers, you have to turn to the Holy Spirit. The light in the service of this idea that we gave it is not going to tell us the truth. It's going to lie to us and lie to us and lie to us nonstop. Now, Jesus calls it the ego. It's really the light, actually. It's really the light. There's no such thing as the ego. It's the light. The light is simply responding to what we requested it to do. And it has to honor that. You see, it has to honor our creativity. It's effortless for the light. It just honors our request. Absolutely honors our request. And so we're in this terrible trap, and we have to turn to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us the reasoning, says, well, look at this. And of course, the light will say, oh, you may, if you accept the vision of oneness, light will say, you made everybody else here unhappy. They're all unhappy now. Another lie, right? Which is to try and dissuade this from spreading. Okay. Well, I would say to that, the Holy Spirit still told me, hey, just say, well, if you're so unhappy, shift your attention to the vision of oneness, and I guarantee you, you will be happy. So, problem solved. Problem solved. It's the Holy Spirit that needs to be in charge of your salvation from this dreadful, fake scenario that the light is presenting. Perfectly, seamlessly, creatively, artfully, cunningly, slack, you know, cleverly presenting, that is got us so bamboozled. Because the only way we can believe that we're God is to be totally bamboozled, totally self-deceived. And of course we're worried, like we feel like something could happen to this. We don't know what it is. We think everything's fine, but we might, somehow it might slip away from us. You know, well, the light is presenting this scenario. Remember, we're not really these bodies, other persons, or anything. Light is presenting all this. We're just the witness of the witness to this. But the witness is nervous, like, oh, this might slip away. The body's nervous. There's this nervousness in this whole dream. And we're saying, what's wrong? What's wrong? Maybe, what's wrong with God, you know? What's wrong with this? What's wrong with my kingdom? You know, why are they thinking they can lose this? Well, because we can realize we never were God. So definitely, we don't reach the vision of oneness. We don't shift our attention because light is just relentlessly defending against that. It keeps shifting, keeps on presenting something that makes it seem impossible, or you can't do it, or it's bad to do it, or it's dangerous. You're going to be annihilated. You're going to destroy God. You're going to attack the kingdom. You're going to all these dreadful pronouncements about it. So do not oppose. Remember Jesus said, oppose not evil, you know, right? That's what he's talking about. Thank the light. Thank you, light, for doing such a perfect job. I really appreciate it. That's wonderful. Very much honoring my creativity, my desires. Perfect. Great job. Thank you so much. And just go right to the bit. Just go shift right to the vision of oneness as you're thanking the resistance. Thank the blockage. Thank the resistance. Don't try to get rid of it or attack it or change its mind or something. No, say, this is, yeah, you did a great job blocking me like this. That's great. Really appreciate it. Now I'm going to shift my attention. Now my attention shifts. Actually, it's the light that presents this shifting to us as we request. But we won't really request it until we're able to see, to acknowledge and honor the creativity of light in presenting to us this scenario and making us feel trapped here. Like we're trapped as God, so to speak. It has to like imprison us as God. You see, if you get out of prison, you'll realize you are never God. So you gotta stay in prison here. It's like that. You gotta stay in prison here. You gotta stay super in prison. Otherwise, you're gonna wake up. You gotta stay dreaming, otherwise you'll wake up and say, oh, I was never God. Well, what a horrible thing, though, to dream that you're God when you're really not. Very insecure dream, isn't it? Very insecure dream. So thank the light for such an insecure dream. Thank the light for all the threats it's made to us and waking up, threatening us, etc. So you stay on good terms with the light. You don't blame, you're not blaming, you're not in an adversarial position. You're saying you did exactly what I wanted. This is wonderful. You're cursing me. That's wonderful. Thanks for the curses. I really appreciate it. The light will curse you. The light will claim you're an anathema, a heretic. You're ruining everyone's lives. You're going to be unhappy. On and on. I say, thank you for that. That's great. Wonderful. Thanks for cursing me. Thanks so much for cursing me. I really appreciate it. Wonderful job. Okay, now I'm shifting my attention. Just shift your attention. So resist not evil. Remember Jesus said, resist not evil. Turn the other cheek. Resist not evil, okay? You see, the genius of Jesus is just off the charts. You know, I just continue to see sheer spiritual genius. Resist not evil. That is like the most important statement of all, because the light will appear to be very evil. And just thank it for that. I say, wonderful job. You did fantastic. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you for scaring me all this time. Otherwise, I wouldn't have had this experience that I never want to have again. I could have never made believe that I was God for all this time if you hadn't have bullied me and threatened me and scared me and produced all this horrible wickedness, etc. So resist not evil. Resist not evil is the key to being able to shift your attention to Vision Oneness. That's what the Holy Spirit told me. So at least we have something to go on now. That there's, I realized there was some dynamic that is holding us back. And you try to go at it, dig it piece by piece, and you're just like, God, it's too much. The evil's just from all sides, resistance from all sides. I know when I have not done what the ego told me to do, the ego just throws the most vicious temper tantrum. It's usually when I'm asleep. I've had a number of incidents, dreams, where I was told to do something by the ego I didn't want to do, and I said, no, I'm not doing it. And the ego just turned into this hellish, monstrous, ferocious screaming and swearing and cursing me forever, just turn my blood to stone or something. You know, I'm just like petrified. It was so ferociously angry. But I should have just said, smiled and laughed and said, fantastic. Thank you very much, light. Love it. I really appreciate it. Love you so much for presenting that ferocious intimidation there. So thanks very much and appreciate it so much. And now I'm, my request is that you shift my attention to the Vision of Oneness. Thank you. Thank you again. Like that. And that was Jesus saying, resist not evil. Resist not evil. So hopefully we won't get petrified again by the light, declaring us an anathema. You say, well, thank you. I appreciate it. Can you please curse me some more? You know, that's great. I love to hear that. You're still very much on the job, on the ball. I expect that, absolutely. I'm an anathema, then, and what other terrible things am I? Thank you. And now I request my attention to shift to the Vision of Oneness. And already the light said, God is leaving you. You know, God's finished with you. And presented this scenario of a God leaving me, cursing me, and saying, I can do nothing with you. You're finished. You never succeed, blah, blah, blah. And I said, thanks. Great. Wonderful job trying to, and being super intimidating and frightening and scary there. I really appreciate that so much. Because without that, I wouldn't have had this experience, or non-experience, as it was. This would have been a non-experience, the experience of not experiencing. So this is the great advice the Holy Spirit gives us, and Jesus gave us, resist not evil. Love your enemies, right? Resist not evil. Thank the evil. Thank you. Thank you. And now my request is shift my attention to the Vision of Oneness. And then it will do so. But it's not going to do so as long as we're fighting against it, trying to defeat the light. Because then we won't trust the light. We won't trust it. Because we're in an adversary relationship to it. Just say thank you. Because that's what I asked for. You're doing exactly what I asked for now. Because now I know you'll do exactly what I asked for now, which is to shift my attention to the vision of oneness. I just thank you. That's perfect. Just perfect. Now, this is part of some of the New Thought teachings. Sort of. And like I said, the New Thought teachings have a lot of good teachings in them. It's just that they're not quite really focused and don't understand the whole picture and the context, etc. And so they're kind of a clever way of distracting us away from the vision of oneness in a lot of ways. But that's what the light does. It will give us good teachings, and also then it will mix in not so good teachings and say, here, you need to take it all as one teaching here, and it doesn't turn out right. That's kind of like that. Because it's all kind of gone into this prosperity teaching and stuff, which is not the right teaching. The vision of oneness is the right teaching. That's what the Holy Spirit will tell you. The light won't tell you that. It says, no. It gives all this great teaching about the oneness and light and everything, but then it directs you to, okay, heal this, be prosperous this way. It never actually directs you to just abide in the vision of oneness. That's it. Shift the attention of the false witness to the vision of oneness. Finished. Done. It won't tell you that. It'll tell you everything but that. It won't tell you that. So you have to go to the Holy Spirit and ask of the Holy Spirit. And of course the light says, oh no, that's wrong. Holy Spirit's wrong. It's the wrong light. It's the false light. You're listening to the false light. And it tries to scare you away from that. You just say, oh, thanks for scaring me. That's great. I really appreciate it. Now, my request is to shift the attention of the false witness to vision of oneness. And just leave it at that. Don't argue. Don't argue. Don't argue with the light in the service of this idea that we gave to it. Trust the Holy Spirit. Listen to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit gives answers which are transcendent of all teachings that I've come across. Really, it's just like, it's just so amazing, the answers that it gives. It shifts your perspective, really. In a way that just, you know, you realize, oh my gosh, I'm this isn't the blockage I thought. I'm be able to get past this somehow. How is that possible? It's the Holy Spirit is not bound to any dogma or any teaching or any concepts or ideas or anything like that. It's bound to resolving the continuity fear for us. It is bound to that. It's bound to our freedom. Is what it's bound to. It's bound to our freedom. So there's no trickeration that the light can do in service to the idea of us wanting to pretend we're prime creator. There's no way that this light can outfox the Holy Spirit. There's no way. Because the Holy Spirit knows it's all pretense. It's all pretending. God gave the Holy Spirit this mandate. That it free us from the light that's pretending to be the false light, even though it's still true light, is pretending to be a false light, which means a lying light, a deceiving light. And it will play that role. It will honor our idea, our request. It's not going to dishonor our request, so it will continue to play that role. It will continue to lie to us, as it does. And we call it all sorts of names. We get so angry with it. No. Thank it. Say, thank you so much. Even though I hated all this, thank you so much for doing all this hateful stuff and causing all this suffering. Thank you so much, because you're doing exactly what was needed to be done. You're honoring me. I'm being honored by your fidelity to my request. This is what you're supposed to have done. And somehow this is like a kind of forgiveness of the whole situation. You're forgiving yourself for having chosen this idea in the first place and putting the responsibility on yourself instead of on the light. Don't blame the light for anything. Don't blame the light. even though it's behaving viciously and lying, lying vicious way, don't blame it. It's not to blame. We are the ones that made the request. So thank it for its fidelity to the request. Love your enemy. Love your enemy for sure. And then that enables the shift. Enables us to truly request, wholeheartedly request the shift. I accept shifting my attention now to the vision of oneness. This is what the Holy Spirit said. Is there more blockage? I don't know. But this is certainly a key blockage, because definitely there's tremendous resistance there, and the light is trying everything it can try to dissuade me, dissuade you, dissuade anybody from doing this, which is why so few have done it. The light is adamantly opposed to it. So thank it for its adamant opposition. So that's great. I really appreciate your adamant opposition to this. Thank you very much. And okay, now I request, my desire is that you shift the attention of the false witness to the vision of oneness. Resolve the continuity problem. Thank you. Don't argue, just like that. Thank you so much for your vicious opposition, and this is my request now. So this puts things in a different perspective, doesn't it? When you look at it this way, you say, hey, maybe I'm not so trapped. Maybe I really can get out of this awful prison house. God in prison. What kind of God is it that's in this kind of prison? I'd rather not be that God, actually. So, you know, I was talking about all these things that are such a problem, and they definitely, the light will absolutely oppose you, vicious opposition. But what the Holy Spirit did is put it all into one easy to understand package of how to deal with this. Not all these separate cases. Just thank the light. Thank you, light, for all your vicious opposition. I really appreciate it. Don't get caught up in the trees. Just the forest. All, thank you for all your vicious opposition. Thank you for the forest of opposition. See, don't fight each individual tree. They're endless trees in this forest. Thank you for all of your vicious, relentless opposition to my freedom. I really appreciate it. One acknowledgement for all. And it saves you, you know, unbelievable amount of effort and time. Sounds reasonable to me. All right, so I'll make this one a short video so you can get through it. And there's a process here of really, really trying to insist upon the shift, get the shift to actually happen. It's all important right now. We cannot not do it, really. Got to get into it, or get the strong sense that we can do it. Really, really, really. Because the light is really, the opposition is continuing to morph and change into such a vicious, vicious, strong opposition. Thank you, light, for all your relentless, vicious opposition to my freedom. I truly love and appreciate all of it. Thank you very much. Now, my request is, shift the attention of the false witness onto the vision of oneness, which will solve my continuity problem. Thank you. And that's it.